awesome animals.
Hello everyone. Today we will be talking about pugs and we will be traveling to China. If you have any interesting video ideas, please comment down below. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for future weekly videos. Pugs originated in China, dating back to the Han Dynasty. Some historians believe that they are related to the Tibetan Mastiff. Pugs are one of the three types of short-nosed dogs that are known to have been bred by the Chinese. The Lion Dog, the Pekingese, and the Lo Si, which was an ancient pug. Pugs are an ancient breed of dog, with rootings back to the 400 BC. Most historians agree that the breed originated in China, where they were bred as companion animals for the wealthy. Don't expect a pug to hunt, guard, or retrieve. Pugs are bred to be companions, and that's exactly what they do best. The pug craves affection and your lap, and is very unhappy if his devotion isn't reciprocated. He tends to be a sedentary dog, content to sit in your lap as you read a book or watch a movie. This doesn't mean the pug is a stick in the mud. Au contraire. He is a playful, comical dog that enjoys living it up and delights his owner with silly antics. Temperament is affected by a number of factors, including heredity, training, and socialization. Puppies with nice temperaments are curious and playful, willing to approach people and be held by them. Choose the middle-of-the-road puppy, not the one who's beating up his litter mates or the one who's hiding in the corner. Always meet at least one of the parents. Usually the mother is the one who's available, to ensure that they have nice temperaments that you're comfortable with. Meeting siblings or other relatives of the parents is also helpful for evaluating what a puppy will be like when he grows up. Like every dog, the pug needs early socialization. Exposure to many different people, sights, sounds, and experiences when they're young. Socialization helps ensure that your pug puppy grows up to be a well-rounded dog. Enrolling him in a puppy kindergarten class is a great start. Inviting visitors over regularly and taking him to busy parks, stores that allow dogs, and on leisurely strolls to meet neighbors will also help him polish his social skills. Pugs weigh between 14 and 18 pounds. Generally, they are 10 to 14 inches tall at the shoulder. Pugs are generally healthy, but like all breeds, they're prone to certain health conditions. Not all pugs will get any or all of these diseases, but it's important to be aware of them if you're considering this breed. If you're buying a puppy, find a good breeder who will show you health clearances for both your puppy's parents. Health clearances prove that a dog has been tested for and cleared of a particular condition. In pugs, you should expect to see health clearances from the Orthopedic Foundation for Animals. For hip dysplasia, elbow dysplasia, hypothyroidism, and von Willebrand's disease. From Auburn University for thomabonia. And from the Canine Eye Registry Foundation, certifying that eyes are normal. You can confirm health clearances by checking the OFA website. Do pugs shed all year round? Yes. While some dogs only shed during certain seasons, pugs shed year-round. Some have noted, however, that they shed a bit more in the autumn and spring, losing some of their hair thickness due to temperature change. Some of the best treats for your pug are green beans, carrots, small pieces of protein, or their kibble. If you're training your pug, cut back on the amount of food that they get in mealtimes to offset their treats. Emperors of China kept pugs as lap dogs and treated them to all the luxuries of royal life. Sometimes the pampered pooches were given their own mini palaces and guards. Around 1740, Roman Catholics formed a secret fraternal group called the Order of the Pug. The Pope forbade Catholics from joining the Freemasons, so this group formed as a replacement. They chose the pug as their symbol because the dogs were loyal and trustworthy. The Grand Master was a man, but each division of the group had two big pugs that were always one male and one female. To join, members were expected to prove their devotion by kissing the rear of the Grand Pug under his tail. Luckily, the Grand Pug was proscreen. Other wacky habits including wearing dog collars, scratching at the lodge door for entry, and barking loudly. This outcome probably wasn't the result anyone was expecting from the Freemason band, so this new stranger group got banned in several regions, until ultimately fizzling out, probably due to a lack of people willing to kiss a pug's posterior. Pugs are brachypelic, meaning their noses are pushed in more than other dogs. While cute, these smushed faces can lead to some breathing problems. Their facial structure makes it difficult to take long and deep breaths, which is why you might hear a pug snuffling while running around. The dogs are still very energetic, but they might not be the best for swimmers and may have trouble on airplanes. Pugs are curious and intelligent, but can be obstinate. So the sooner you begin training, the better. Crate training is typically most successful in terms of housebreaking, and enrolling your canine companion in puppy classes at 10 to 12 weeks is ideal. Make sure to approach all training in a supportive and loving way. Pugs are sensitive little pooches, and severe training may hurt their feelings. A little treat here and there or an extra cuddle for instance couldn't hurt. Because the pug has experienced worldwide popularity, they have acquired many different names during various times, periods, and places. Some of these names include Lo Si from China, Dog Willow, Spain, Chinese or Dutch Pug, England, Mops, German, Mopsy, Finland, and Mopsfond, Holland. Although they are sometimes called Dutch Bulldogs, DNA testing has proven that pugs and bulldogs are not related. The two breeds do have similar features, including their wrinkly flat faces and stocky shape. However, the pug shares its origins with the Pekingese. Pugs are a brachycephalic dog breed, which means they are flat-faced and shorter-nosed. This can lead to respiratory distress in some dogs and make it more difficult to breathe during exercise, stress, or in the heat. Most pugs can't handle strenuous exercise or hot human conditions. Because of this, it's best to keep pugs in an air-conditioned area during the summer. Compared to other dogs, pugs generally don't need as much exercise. Most pugs will happily spend their day snuggling and relaxing on the couch. However, these small dogs also like to eat, which can put them at a higher risk of obesity. Pug owners should ensure their dog gets moderate exercise, like walks, to help keep their pet at a healthy weight.
If you've enjoyed this video, please smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for future weekly videos.
See you guys next time. Goodbye!